गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। इन लास्ट क्लास वी आर डिस्कस्ड गार्बेज कलेक्शन कॉन्सेप्ट इन जावा। नाउ टुडेज क्लास वी कैन डिस्कस क्लासेस एंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन जावा। फर्स्ट वी कैन डिस्कस जावा क्लासेस। देन यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट the concept of class. Class is a blueprint or prototype of the object. For example, the student class having a objects as a student's name, that is XYZ, ABC, PQR. XYZ, ABC and PQR are three objects are belonging to student class. And second, roll number of the student. Every student have a different roll number, like roll number 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 objects are belonging to the student's class. Student is a class. It is a blueprint of objects. I hope you understand this example. Here, see. A class is a user-defined blueprint or a prototype from which objects are created. It represents the set of properties or a methods that are common to all the objects of the one type. It means student is a class, name and roll number are the properties of the class. Class is a blueprint or a prototype of the object, and also it represents the set of properties or a methods that common to all the objects. Class declaration can include following components. First one is modifier. A class can be public or a has default as a specifier. Second one is class name. Class name, the name should begin with the initial letter. Initial means it's always start from capital letter. Class name must be start from capital letter. Then third one is super class. If any super class are there in your coding, then you can use super class. Otherwise we need not bother about that super class. The super class of the class's parents, if any, proceed by the keyword extends. The super class can be processed with the keyword extends. With this keyword we can create a super class. A class can only extend a subclass. One class can extend only one subclass. Subclass means that is child class. Super class means parents class. That means own class. From that class we are extending a child class, that is subclass. And super class can be processed by the keyword extend. Then next one is interface. If any interfaces are there in your coding, then you can use interface concept in class. Otherwise, we need not bother. A comma separated the list of interfaces implemented by the class. If any proceed keyword implements, a class can implement more than one interface. Interface can proceed by the keyword implement. With the help of implement keyword, we can use interface concept in our coding. A class can implement more than one interface. In superclass, only one subclass we can extend, but here we can implement more than one interface in our coding. And finally, class consists of body, that is surrounded by the braces, opening our braces and closing our braces. These five are the component of the classes. In your exam, the question may be arise, what is Java classes and what are the component of Java classes? For this, you can write this. First one is modifier, class name, superclass, interface, final one is body. These five are the component of the class. Next, we can discuss object concept. You already know that. What is object means? Object is a real world entity. It may be anything. It may be a pen, it may be a book, it may be a table, it may be a chair, it may be a blackboard, it may be a duster, it may be anything. The things which are going to identifiable, those are all called as objects. Here, see, it is a basic unit of the object-oriented programming and represents the real-world entity. Objects is a basic unit of object-oriented programming and it represents the real-world entities. A typical Java program creates many objects which, you know, interact by the invoking methods. The objects are created with the help of the programming you are writing. That means the object, you can take a object as a pen, table, chair. You can take any example of objects. An object consists of these following components. First one is state. Now we can see what this state represents. It represents by the attribute of the object. It also reflects the properties of an object. State means it reflects the properties of the object. For example, you can take pen. What is the properties of the pen? With the help of pen, what are all the things we can do? First one is we are writing from the pen. The properties is writing. The object name is pen, properties is writing. Then second is behavior. It represents by the method of the object. It also reflects the responses of an object with the other object. It represents the behavior of the object. It means what is the behavior of pen? With the help of pen, we can write. Write is the property and also behavior of the object pen. Then third one is identity. It gives a unique name to the object that enables one object interact with the other object. Identity means the object can interacted with the other object. It means the pen object can interacted with the other object. For example, you can take pen. Pen object, you can use this pen object in our coding, and at the end by calling the method we can use a pen object to create new object. Pen p new equal to pen, it means new p object can be created in our programming. How to create a object and how to use that object and how to use that object in a method, we can all discuss in further classes. Now only you concentrate the concept of objects. I think the object concept you can understand. Next, the new keyword in Java. The Java new keyword is used to create an instance of a class. In other words, it instantiate a class by allocating a memory for a new object and returning a references to that object. We can also use the new keyword to create an array. The new keyword used to create a new object which are going to be used for calling a method from class name. Then the new keyword is also used to creating a array objects. Syntaxes for the new keyword is new example, object equal to new example. It means in previous class example I can use a pen object. Pen is a object. For this pen object we can create a new object called p equal to new keyword. We are using a new keyword to create a object. Then also finally we can use pen for opening and closing braces for the creating a p object from a pen. We can use syntax is object name, new object equal to new keyword, then the object name, braces, parenthesis for the closing parenthesis and opening and closing parenthesis, and colon. For this syntax we are used to create a object. Point to be remembered to use the new keyword in our coding. First is it is used to create the object. New keyword is used to create an object, and it's allocate the memory at a runtime. It allocate the memory at a runtime for our programming. All objects are occupy memory in a heap area. What are all the objects we have created in our program? That all objects are created and occupy the memory in our heap area. It invoke the object constructor. And final one is it requires a single POSIX argument to call a constructor. It is used a POSIX argument to call the constructor. These 5 points are the remember to using a new keyword in our program. In your exam the question may be arise, what are all the points to remember for the new keyword, or what are all the uses or properties of a new keyword. For that question, you may answer for these 5 points. I think you understand this. Next, the example of a new keyword. Here, see, first one is we created the class. Class name with new example. Then wire display is a method. In that method, we are going to print invoking method with the help of system.out.println. Then this is the public static void main, string args. This is the main method. In this method, we are going to create a new object. New example 1, obj equal to new. New example 1. In here, the obj object is created. For that new object, we can calling a display method by the obj.display. The output is the invoking method. Simple. First, we can declare the class name. In that class, the method we are defined. In main, we are creating one object. From that object, we are calling the display method. It is the example of new keyword. Now, we can discuss both the object and class example. Object and class example, main within the class. It means within a class, we are writing a main method. See, in this example, we have created a student class which has two data members, ID and name. We are creating the object of the student class by new keyword and printing the object's value. Here we are going to create a main method inside the class. Here, see. First one is public static void. Sorry. For this, main within the class example is here, the file name is student.java. Class is a keyword. Student is a class name. In this, int id, string name. These are the data members. For this, we are creating a main method and creating a new object from the student and system.out.println. In this, we are calling the data members. Here, accessing members through the reference variables. For S1 object, we are going to call the ID and also we are going to call the name. For S1 is, we cannot declare any value because it going to print a 0. For name, we did not mention any values to the name variable. Because of that, it prints a null value. See here, the output is for S1.id is 0, S1.name is null. In class, we are declaring a main method. Second one, object and class example, main outside the class. For previous example, we can declare a main method within the class. In this, we can declare the main method outside the class. In real-time development, we are creating a class and use it from another class. First, we can create the class. Then, we are use that in other class. it is better to approach than previous one. Let's see a simple example where we are having the main method in another class. We can have a multiple classes in a different Java file or a single Java file. If you define a multiple classes in a single Java source file, it is a good idea to save the file name with a class name. The file name must same as the class name which has main method. The every Java file name must be same as the main method of the class name. Class name of the main method and the file name both are the same in our every Java programming. Here see the example. File name is teststudent1.java. Here the class name is student. Data members are id and name. Id is int id, string name. In this, creating an another teststudent1 which contains the main method. Because of class name is teststudent1. Teststudents1 and teststudent1 of the file name both are same because the teststudent1 includes the main method. Which class having the main method that is same as file name? In this, we are declaring the main method, public static void main string as. In this main method, we are creating a S1 object with the new keyword, and we are printing a S1.id and S1.name with the help of system.println. The output is for id and name, we didn't initialize any value. Because of that, the output is 0 and null. This is the best example of the class. Two classes having a one method. The class name of the class name which includes the main method, that is, and the file name must be same. This is the example of main outside the class. I hope you all understand this concept. In next class, we are going to discuss the further topics. Thank you.